Hey y'all, welcome back. This is my second day in Las Vegas. Lord, do I have a story for y'all. Anyway, we ain't gonna address that. I went to Savers today over on, I don't know the name of the street. I don't know. I actually walked, y'all. I left the hotel. I walked, it was about 20 minutes. It said a mile, but it was roughly maybe a tad more. I got down there and there was a 99-cent store down there, a Burger King. I found a Wingstop. So I got my food. I can smell it. I got to eat. But I wanted to do this because I'm going to be doing a live video tonight around 7 Eastern, 7 p.m. Eastern, maybe a tad minutes before, maybe a tad minutes after, because I think it's already like 6 now. But I'm going to eat real fast. Then I'm going to do the live and I'll show you why I'm going to do it. Anyway, guess what I found? I found y'all. Remember, look how dirty that is. It don't even matter. This is Le Creuset, and all of that will come off, y'all. Le Creuset. You see that? This thing will be cleaned up, y'all. Remember I found this in blue a couple weeks ago in Dallas? This one was only $3.99, and it wasn't on sale. This was at Savers. $3.99, Le Creuset saute pan. $100 pan, y'all. $100. Y'all sell that online when I showed you last time. Then I didn't get much because the prices are totally different. And when you think about the fact that I would have to pay to ship it back. Now this pan I could fit in between my clothes and it'll be fine. But guess what else I got? This is why I'm going live. I'm gonna open this jewelry jar. It doesn't look to be extremely promising, but it's a jewelry jar. I thought it would be fun. I know the lighting is bad, y'all. This hotel room has horrible lighting. $14.99. Let me see if I can open this up. See, the sun's starting to go here. I need y'all. $14.99 for this. Don't know what's in it. It's not even full, but it's a jewelry jar. We'll see what it is. Okay, then I found this, and I'm going to make this fit in my luggage, too. I just thought it was so cute. Oh, I got it upside down. Look at that, a tea light holder with the beautiful crystals on it. Thought that was so pretty. This was $5.99 and it wasn't on sale. I just thought it was cute. And I was trying to just like, I figure probably could I have gotten it cheaper, but no, I don't know, you know? Look at that, you like that? Cute, y'all. Okay, and then I got this little ring. And it's so cute. It's stainless steel, I think. I think this is stainless steel. But it's so cute. Look at that. Cute little ring. It was $1.99. So I just got it. A little pinky ring. $1.99. Where it's silver. I thought that was cute. And I got one other thing. Oh, this. Y'all, look at that. Do you know what that is? Yep, found Bakelite. And Bakelite, it was $3.99. And look, I did the smell real quick while I was standing there. I said, because they had this hanging there. I said, yup, I got it. So I got it. This was $3.99. So I got this. I'll be getting that out of here. And other than that, I got some. That's all I got, y'all, thrifting. Oh, what, from the 99-cent store, I got this bag because I was looking for a tote bag, you know, just to carry my wares back to the hotel because I walked down there and I got a lift bag, that lift service. And then the last thing, that's my snack for tonight. I got some Fritos. I got this. This is by Ralph Lauren. It's one of those free with perfume purchases. See that? But I figured if I did go to another thrift store tomorrow or the next day and I found some stuff, I'll just pay the $45 to have a carry-on and I could take my stuff in this bag. Because I paid for one bag, but as long as I do it 24 hours before I head out, I can get another bag. I'll just pay it. You know, if I don't, this will be folded up very tiny, tiny and put in that luggage and go home with me. So it's like a weekender. So that's it. But for what I got right now, I know I could wrap this stuff up and throw this into my luggage. But yeah, look at this less than 5 minute video. Y'all, the room I got yesterday, I was in tears. Yeah, this has been a nightmare. I got in the room, and then, child, it was Hood City. Now, let me tell y'all. I'll tell this in a different story, but I just say this to say this. I am not talking about anybody's neighborhood or anybody's town because I grew up and was raised in Camden, New Jersey, okay? And I was a cop there. That's my hood. I'm comfortable there. And somebody else might come there and be scared to death. You know what I mean? Or be very weary of the town. Me, I'm fine there. I'm comfortable there. Crime could be going on all around me, and I'm fine with it, you know? So that's what I'm saying. I'm in a part, this hotel is in a part, is not the best of neighborhoods. And if it's not your hood, you're not as comfortable. Although I'm comfortable wherever I want go, because like I said, I walk down and nice through neighborhoods to get to that store. I don't show fears. The whole thing is showing fears. I just don't show fear. You come to me, you have a fight. But in the hotel over there, they put me in the area where they have smoking. Yo, Lord have mercy. Y'all, the fools was out. It was just noise, rap music. The walls was paper thin. You could hear the whole conversation. And the conversations were not legal. Let's just say that. So I called down to the hotel and I was like, look, I did not book this room. This is a room you guys gave me. I don't want that room. I want what I booked because I'm in the vintage part, which is vintage. I've learned my lesson. And like I said, I'm going to have a whole review on this. I'm not saying it's a bad hotel. I'm just saying if you come here, you might not want to book it. That's all I'm saying. So, you know, because people can tell you things about how nice it is and I was there and this and that. But until you experience it for yourself, like I would never do this again. I would never do this again. I mean, I'm definitely going to keep traveling and keep going places and finding places like this. But this was my experience. And yeah, it's been a mess. But I'm in another room. And I'm going to show y'all that maybe on the live or maybe in tomorrow's video. I got in here late last night because last night I was on the phone trying to find a flight home. Oh, I was going to go home last night, y'all. I was on the Tammy had to talk me off the cliff. But they put me in a room where I'm comfortable. It's okay. And like I said, after I get the full experience of here, I'll speak on it. But I just gave y'all I touched on it a little bit. But other than that, I'm going to be going live in a few. I want to upload this video and eat and then check me out let's check out and see what's going on in this jar. Okay, guys, I'll talk to you later. Thanks a lot for all the well wishes. I know last night I didn't get a chance to answer comments and then I was out all day today. Just got back in. But I'm going to. Last night I had a headache. All this switching rooms. Now you see why I couldn't get into the comments. By 8:45, I was so tired, y'all. I got in that shower. Didn't want to, but I did because I couldn't sleep without getting in the shower. So I did. And then I got in the bed and I went to sleep. I woke up at 3:30. I was up for about 45 minutes. I went right back to sleep. Woke back up at 8 something this morning. And then I got up and got dressed and got out. But I am getting to the comments and I appreciate them. I was glancing through them while I was out. So I'll see you guys later. All right. Bye-bye.